Hi everyone, this is Nehama from Arc Intelligence, and in this video I will show you how to model your roof gardening design in Revit with accurate grading and material volume scheduling. The main issue with creating roof gardening in Revit is that you actually have to have two separate slopes. The bottom slope to drain the structural floor and another for the top gardening surface. Now, a floor with different top and bottom slope in Revit is basically not allowed. So you can't create a two-direction variable material on one floor element. But there are a couple of solutions, and in this video, I will show you one of them. In this example, I have a building designed with an underground structure, and I want to design a garden on top of it. The first part is to make sure all the water from the garden drains to a certain point to prevent leaks. To do that, I added another floor on top of the roof. This floor has a variable material to indicate the volume of concrete needed to create the slope. In this case, I exaggerated the slope to make this example more visible, but a simple 1% slope will usually do. Once the bottom grading is done, you need to model the surface of the garden. The easiest way to do it is to create topographies as a reference for the final design. Let's unhide the reference surfaces I've recreated for my garden by turning on the visibility to its filter. You can learn more about the different ways to model surfaces with Environment for Revit on our YouTube channel. Now here is the cool part. For the finished grading of the gardening area, I created again another floor type with a variable material. I will use this floor type to model two flat floors, each for every side of the path. Now in a section view, let's locate these floors so the bottom of each floor is within the concrete floor type. Next, let's go to a 3D view, isolate both floors and the reference surfaces, and go to Environment tab to use Shape by Topography command to shape the top of the slabs by the reference surfaces. To get a better accuracy, I will include all elevation points from the surface into the floor. This can take a while, depending on the complexity of the surface you design. Once we're done and the floors are perfectly shaped and graded, let's hide the help surfaces and the lines. To change the slope of the bottom surface of the floor, I will now use the Join Geometry command to subtract the concrete volume from the floor volume. This will change the appearance of the top floor cut, but you can manually edit the appearance. We can isolate the floors in 3D and see the new geometry created on the bottom of these floors. Let's go through the simple steps once more. Use a slab with a variable material for the bottom concrete grading. Use another slab with a variable material for the finish grading and place it within the concrete slab. Join the geometry of these two floors to cut the topsoil into the concrete shape volume. Thank you for watching this video. Please like and subscribe for more videos